for profit.
That's what society, but that's then, but that's been around since Adam and Eve. You know what I'm saying?
Put, and Jezebels back then was labeled as whores.
We're not gonna go there, but
please, okay, we're not. We're not. Let me get me a cup.
Hey, take me a drink, man. But my thing is like, how would you take that? Would you go off on a female? Would you be like, okay? That's what I'm saying. Put yourself
depends
in that situation.
On how good
what would
the
you
pussy
do?
Is.
And be keep it real.
I'm gonna keep it real. I think it's all on this guy because labels do mean something a lot in America. You have supervisor, you have girlfriend, you have boyfriend.
Okay,
if
you
wife, husband. If you are none of those things, if you don't even have a label and you just a motherfucker, come on up, start hitting some pussy and was lucky to get some pussy, and then all of a sudden it made a transaction to the next level and you caught feelings and shit, then you the old sucker ass nigga. You don't have a title, you don't have none, you just a nigga that got lucked up on some pussy and got in your feelings. Let's be real. Whoever this nigga is, man, he was fucking some good pussy and fell in love with it, but then the bitch was like, you ain't on shit. Nah, I'm finna run you up a check.
What you think?
I mean, I agree. Cause I mean, from I don't know what's going on, but if you was getting it for free already, you know what I'm saying, and then she just come up with this,
it was a mishap somewhere.
Yeah, something had to go wrong. Cause I mean, either she felt like she was entitled to something and wasn't getting it, or she.
I'm back on this nigga. Fuck that. Look, whatever was going on in her life, okay. It's her business. But he caught feelings. So he need to get checked. Man,
I mean,
law.
When you getting it for
pull
free,
charges up on this man. He need to get checked. Why he in his feelings? Move on to the next
bitch. He
was
getting it for free. He probably was paying everybody else. And he was just like, you know what? I'm tired of paying bitches. I need to get it for free. You know what I'm saying? And she started giving it to him. He was like, okay, I might got one. Now, oh, damn. Another motherfucking bitch that wants some goddamn money. Goddamn, bitch.
What a disappointment.
It happens.
It happens, man.
Yeah. Tell a listener, man, be okay. Hey, it's okay.
My thing is like, if we started out one way, don't try to change it up with me in the bottom of the ninth. When goddamn it, when you down to your ass pitcher.
The bottom of the ninth too late though, because I mean, if you change it up, like I mean, a situation gonna change either way. Either y'all gonna start fucking for real, or he's gonna.
It's just time to move around.
My thing is, if it level up to that, don't just fucking say, goddamn it, I can't fuck for free. Be like, listen, man. We've been fucking around.
Right, exactly. Down. Her approach should have been
different. I'm digging you. You digging me. Maybe we should take it to the next level.
What you gonna do?
Right. What you want? Is that the wrong approach?
No, that's a better approach than she had. Then you gotta start paying.
He literally said it like that. He literally said she said it like that.
But did she say it like that?
I don't know.
We don't know the facts.
That's what he said.
But listen, I don't know. I don't know. Because it depends on what he was on and she was on. I wish she was here so we could tell him, like, bro, you tripping.
You got it. That's another thing. You got to get different people in, man.
Yeah.
You got to get a female in.
I thought Mary Jane Cashflow was going to come through this bitch, because you know what I'm saying?
I thought she was too, but.
You know, she be out on tour, whatever, spitting the flow.
Ain't nothing wrong with that, man. Ain't nothing wrong with that. We're going to get into a little bit more music, come back and talk a little bit more. This is the all-new Live and Direct show with the homie St. Cool and the mad motherfucking listener.
Hey, yes, what sir. Shout out to Johnny Cool. Man, not a blunt. It's opening up. No homo.
Hey, St. Cool,
just hit
brother.
My motherfucker. Man, I ain't finna call you no St. Cool.
You already did.
We back on this again.
Johnny Cool.
We back
Johnny
on this
Cool.
Why is you? Cool.
We in this bitch getting high, nigga.
We down here in the Playa Cave, just chilling, man. Just talking about a lot of open subjects, man. Just, you know, just floating through. We just got through talking about relationships. We talked about the finals and everything else. When we come back, man, we gonna talk about us black folks. What's the problem with us, man? Why are we so against each other? That's the question, man.
Shit finna get real.
Yeah, it's finna get real.
Oh, yeah. So, take a drink.
We're going to be back. Going to have us a sip. Going to have us a smoke. I enjoy the music. This is the all-new Live and Direct show. K. catch it at 10 o'clock on the website.
I thought I loved you so. I thought I loved you so.
Days in the OAA, bounce so low. Most fools couldn't price me, silent stunt with a blunt full of PE. And I guess you know me, been in NY so long. Gotta trust they family, especially Brooklyn. Shout out to the Mahdi's. My bloodline runs deep, bitch, I don't sleep. Figure it's my pops keeping me away. Help me keep my mind in the clouds for reality. These motherfuckers can't fathom the wizardry. Slow mo brain ass backwards cowards. Shower, your attitude stinks, soon to know what I think. Hey, my mojo so dope, bitch. My mojo so dope.
Yeah, we live it, live it. Yeah, we own it, own it. Give a fuck about your lifestyle. Give a fuck about a motherfucker lifestyle. Cause nigga, we live this shit. Give a fuck about your lifestyle. Lifestyle,
hey, I live through words, not metaphors, so I pass to be the rest of the freshmen. Play for Tartar, off in the fade till I came like Pogart, said true things. A whole new legion of some niggas aiming high past the eye, this slang, and praise Allah for keeping me away, man. A lot of my niggas fell victim to the dope game. Some things will never be the same. I could tell my brother something for some motivation to get him out that gutter. He's leaving behind a family and a mother. Damn, you must understand what I speak about this song. It's how I really am. Yeah, this is how I really think. You can see what I see. Yes, I really blink. Yes, I really drink. I really do rage. My demons at the cage by most of the day. Before I began the age to even rage, I was drowning my sorrows with some OE, nigga. Hey, we live this shit.
Oh, oh, oh.
Hey, my mojo so dope, bitch. My mojo so dope.
Yeah, we live it, live it. Yeah, oh, we own it, own it. Give a fuck about your lifestyle. Give a fuck about a motherfucker lifestyle. Cause nigga, we live this shit.
Oh, oh, oh.
Give a fuck about your lifestyle. Give a fuck about a motherfucker lifestyle. Cause nigga,
yeah.
Direct show right here in the Playa Cave. Well, we right down here in the Playa Cave. You can catch it at 10 o'clock on Bring Your Game Sports Talk. We sit down and watch the sports. You can catch it on the Blaq Hippie Radio Entertainment website, man. We down here discussing a few subjects, man. We talked about a little bit of sports. Talked about the NBA Finals that's coming up tomorrow, June 1st. We discussed, what was that? Relationships. You know, one of the listeners and callers, you know, left and had something we wanted to discuss and get the players' point of view about everything. You know, we discussed that, but now discussing something a little bit more serious. Why is it that us as black folks, we can't uplift each other? You know, why is we constantly against each other? I'm gonna let you kick it off, Sanko.
Well, yeah.
Because I know this is a subject you was waiting on.
Yeah. Because I don't know what the problem is. But I know what we do to each other, you know what I'm saying? And it's crazy that it's still happening. And by now, we should know what the fuck's going on. Like, if you ain't... I ain't gonna say if you ain't woke at you want some bullshit, but, like, how is it that it's 20... What we in?
2017.
And we still, like, fucked up in here as a people. It's because we... It's the crab in the bucket effect.
I wouldn't say we fucked up as a people, but
we are.
You know what? I would say we might have a chip on our shoulders. We might have a a mental issue itself, because we know what we've been through. We know we the only race that got pulled over here. We was forced over. Everybody else basically is trying to get over here. And that's what it is.
But I understand that though. But
we can't. We was kings and queens
we here,
in Africa.
Okay, but we,
you know,
we here,
was pulled over here,
and this is what I'm
and
saying.
And talk this lifestyle.
We got to get past that, because we here. We've been here for years now, hundreds of thousands of years. So
open mic discussion.
I feel where you're coming from, and I feel that you sound like you upset.
No, we need to get it together.
The crime rate, us killing each other. I feel your pain. I see what you're going through. I see what you're talking about. And you know what? When I watch the news and when I see what's going on in the streets, I get upset and I'm frustrated as well. But at the same time, you cannot give up on your own people.
It is a cycle that needs to be broken down.
Somewhere, somebody got to break the chain, and then the music played. I mean, music played a big factor.
The music is the main thing.
Yeah, that played a large part. And like a lot of evolution of black people. Like, we always had music.
What attracts us, because it's in our soul, man.
It's in our soul. Music is in our soul. So when we hear this music and Molly Perkins said,
it's our future. I like that song, man.
That's my shit, though. Shout out to Future, man. I fuck with you.
But listen, but listen. Check it out.
I ain't never popped no Molly. I ain't never popped no kids that's listening.
And that's where people have to separate entertainment from reality.
But how many people can do that?
I ain't gonna lie, I done done it all. You know what? It is what it is. You know, shit, raw and uncut. You know, you can get no raw than that.
That's why you can.
You probably can relate.
Right, you can relate
to the music.
I can relate. But at the same time, the shit that they put out now.
I don't want my son doing Molly's and Percocets or my daughters.
I ain't got no sons. I ain't got no daughters. I'm out here. It is what it is.
You know, so it's a large part of what we do is like, you know, as a role model set, as a model set, you get what I'm saying?
Right.
And I think that's part of the problem, too, of why we can't rise up out of that, because we see so much shit, and we see these motherfuckers flashing, and we be like, damn, I need that flash, too. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And by the mind being so young, you see all that glory and everything else, you want it.
And that's another problem, because the people, like, I think I heard J. Cole say some shit, he did a song called Be Free on David Letterman that was cold as hell. Y'all should
Be Free Dope.
Yeah, Be Free Dope. But he said some shit in there early. He said, I turned it on the TV and I don't see no brothers finishing college and leaving early. J. Cole, I don't want to try to quote, bro, because you know, I've been drinking and shit. But he said a line like that, and it made me think, like, because the people that
you remind me of that nigga.
The people that we look up to are the people that we are surrounded by. So if we're surrounded by people that's, you know what I'm saying, flashing money and, you know what I'm saying, selling drugs, buying these cars and all
what you see
shit,
is what's gonna get repeated.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what you want. So you are a product of your environment, so to speak.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And the environment we're put in, we not, you know what I'm saying, it's not chosen for us. You know what I'm saying? That was given to us. Mm-hmm. When we came into this world, that's where we was at. And we adapted to that surrounding, and our surrounding was fucked up from the beginning. We never was supposed to be here, for one.
That's what I said in the beginning, though.
Yeah, I know. I'm saying with you. When you said that, I agree with you.
We was kings
and
queens.
But what I'm saying is,
prince and princess.
Not all those were, because it was peasants all over the world.
Yeah, okay, we had those as well, you know.
I'm saying somebody got
to
be.
Y'all do.
It's levels to everything.
Y'all do know black folks are indigenous to America soil, right? That they have found like bones from years ago, and they got pyramids.
I mean, because people think
they actually got a pyramid down in what's that, Collinsville, Illinois.
And a lot of us
weren't actually brought to different parts of land on these boats, because I think that's what history wants to teach us, to get our mindset that way, the way it is. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
But
you do have those black folks,
they weren't slaves. They were scientists, mathematicians, they were doctors, they were dentists, they were mothers, they were fathers, they were uncles, they were nephews, they were nieces, they were aunties. So they wasn't slaves. They actually brought those people over here. And yeah, they brought some people over here, but